Hey everyone, welcome to another edition of my Partridge Family collection. And I'm back at the turntable and I'm kind of doing a part two of an episode that we did a few episodes ago where we talked about this promo record that I have in my collection. And it's one of those nights, you might recall, if you had a chance to watch that episode. Really deep dive on the promo record and why it was important, how it was used in those days. And the reason I'm doing a part two or kind of like a supplement episode to that is because I skipped over something very important when it came to this promo record and actually was called out on it on TikTok. Of course, TikTok, right? And I did skip over something very important, and I'm just going to play a couple snippets of this. I played the whole thing. If you want to go back, and I'll put the link to that other episode that we did on when we did the deep dive on the promo and why it was important and all the cool things about this record. But this is a White Lable promo, and the White Lable promo is a little different. And like I said, I skipped over something that I think is kind of important. I started thinking about it and I'm like, should I go back and re-record it? That episode, or should I just do a part two? But I'm thinking I'd do a part two because it's not, I don't think it warrants a whole episode, but it is kind of interesting. And if you're a record collector, if you're a vinyl collector, or you know, if you're an audiophile or anything like that, this might be somewhat interesting to you. And if you're not, and you just like think, you know, you like cool things about records, then this might be interesting to you as well. So I thought I'd revisit it and go over the thing that I skipped over. I'm going to play a little snippets of this so that you can see what we're talking about. But anyway, so what I skipped over was, this is, of course, is a promo record. And let me actually take it out of the sleeve here, which is the original sleeve, by the way. And the promo record, and like I said, if you want to know more about the promo records, I'll put that link on our show notes and you can go back and watch that because it's pretty interesting. And like I said, as you can see, it says promotional copy, not for sale. And the interesting thing about the White Lable promo records, and there's tons of promo records out there, the White Lable promos are different in that they have the same song on both sides. And if you say it's One of Those Nights, Yes Love, which was released in, this promo was released in 1971. The record was actually released in 1972. And on the other side, like you saw, I just flipped it over. It's got the same song. It's One of Those Nights, Yes Love. And then you flip it over. It's One of Those Nights, Yes Love. And then the White Labels are pretty much all like that. They all have the same song on each side, but they're not exactly the same. There's something different about them. And I'll show you what that is. Something that I skipped over, didn't talk about on that last episode, but like I said, some people were kind of calling me out on it, and so I wanted to revisit it. As you can see, the label says promotional copy, not for sale. It has the name of the song and the Partridge Family, starring Shirley Jones featuring David Cassidy. It's got all the information and everything. And then the thing that's different is you'll see this has a star and it says stereo. So when we turn it around, it's the exact same label. All the stuff is there, promotional copy, not for sale, all the information. Except on this corner here, it does have the red star, but it doesn't say stereo like this one, this side. Listen, see that? And that's because this side is actually not stereo, it's mono. And this promotional copy was sent to radio stations. And in the early 70s, you know, stereo was still kind of a new thing. I don't know if you remember that, but we were listening to music on AM radio stations and they were primarily mono. And so what would happen is, you know, they would send this record to a radio station, regardless if it was an FM radio station or an AM radio station. AM primarily played mono records. They didn't have the capability to play stereo. And FM radio stations played stereo. They had that capability to play the stereo sound system. And they had two drivers, you know, two or more drivers, so you can hear it stereo. I don't know if you remember in the 70s, like when we first heard stereo, like that blew our minds. Like, especially if you had headphones and you listened to something that was recorded stereo, stereophonic, you could hear like the sound would come from one side of the speaker and it would feel like it was going through your brain over to the other side of the speaker in your headphones. And the same if you had like a stereo system, you'd have it set up, you know, and I'm like, man, it's so cool. The Beatles were really great at that, as creating stereophonic sound. With the mono, it would only, if you were to play a mono record on a stereo system, it would only play in one speaker. So that was kind of the difference. But on a radio station, a lot of the times the record companies at that time, they didn't want to exclude the AM stations, right? I mean, I'm sure it would have cost them more money if they were to make a mono record, you know, make two records, or, you know, press two records, one stereo, one mono. So this way they were able to do one pressing, one side mono, one side stereo. They can send it out mass, you know, delivery or whatever to these radio stations. And if it was an AM station, they would play the mono, or they could play the stereo. Actually, if you played stereo on a mono system, one speaker system, it sounds the same. It does not really, you can't really tell the difference. But if you were to play a mono on a stereo, like FM radio station, that kind of defeated the purpose of having, like, you know, stereo, having like two drivers. And like on my turntable, I have a Bluetooth stereo. I actually have two speakers. But if you were to play this on a Bluetooth speaker that just is like one driver, it wouldn't matter if you played the mono side or if you played the stereo side. It would still sound kind of the same. And even on today's Bluetooth speakers, from what I understand, it's like some of them do have two drivers, but they're so close together, it kind of sounds like one. So I'm fortunate that I do have Bluetooth speakers with two speakers. So, and then I'm gonna play this for you, and I'm gonna like just play a snippet of the stereo on the stereo side, and then flip it over and play the mono side. See if we could tell the difference. I don't know if I could tell the difference, but I think it'd be kind of fun to do. So I just kind of wanted to go back. Explain that to you, the white label. I mean, if you're a collector, maybe you're a new vinyl collector, if you come across a white label promo, and I've got a ton of promo records, especially the Partridge Family, and they have different songs on each side. You know, they have the A side and the B side. This is like the record that's coming out that you have to go and buy. But the white labels, if you are, you know, if you're a Partridge Family collector or another band collector or whatever, and you see a white label promo, grab it, because they're rare, and it's interesting, you know, because you have one side stereo, one side mono. And, you know, today I don't think mono is really relevant anymore. Most of the AM stations are talk radio. They're not really playing music. And I don't know, they might have the capabilities to play stereo. I mean, I'm like I said, I'm not an expert on vinyl, not an expert on mono or stereo. I know that, like, when I'm buying vinyl, like old vinyl, like Beach Boys or, you know, some type of band like that, I like the mono, because I know that, especially in the mid 60s, they were laying down one track and they weren't laying down like all different tracks, you know, so that now you hear like all this, you know, all the music in different places. But stereo is basically more spacious, right? It's more spatial. It gives you some type of depth, where the mono, like I said, it's just one track, one speaker. It's laid down, and that way you hear it is the way that it was recorded. And like a lot of the mid 60s bands and before that, that's how they recorded their songs on these tracks. And so they're mono. It wasn't until, you know, they started coming out with the stereos and stereo system that they started laying down different tracks. And the Beatles, like I said, were really big at that. And then of course the Partridge Family did that as well. You have the stereo, and then on the other side, mono. So let's go to the turntable and play this, and we're gonna see if we could tell the difference. I thought that might be kind of fun. Let's do it.
Okay, first we'll play the stereo, and I'll play the first, a little snippet of the first part, and then I'll flip it over and play the mono and see if we can tell the difference here. Remember, I have two speakers, two Bluetooth speakers, so I'll be playing on the right and the left.
It's one of those nights when you turn out the lights and you sit in the dark and say to yourself, I miss her. It's one of those moods when your body moves and you conjure up her picture and you kiss her. One of those things for the pain it brings. You say to yourself, hey, couldn't I live without it? Well, I think so. On the other hand, I doubt it. It's one of those nights when you turn out the lights and you sit in the dark and say to yourself, I miss her. It's one of those moods when your body broods and you conjure up her picture and you kiss her. It's one of those things for the pain it brings. You say to yourself, hey, couldn't I live without it? Well, I think so. On the other hand, I doubt it.
I hope you enjoyed that. You know, like I said, I'm not like a professional collector. I'm not an expert on vinyl. I'm not an expert on anything, actually, other than, you know, that I like to collect Partridge Family stuff. And so when I'm showing something cool like that promo record, I wanted to make sure that I didn't skip over something that might be interesting. And it's kind of interesting. I don't know if we were really able to hear the difference. I mean, that this record, like I said, it was released in 1971, so it's old. It's got some warping to it. I mean, we can kind of hear that warping, right? Kind of cool, kind of interesting to note, and I think that it was too interesting not to mention. So apologies if you didn't see the previous episode where we went into a deep dive on the promo record. I highly suggest you go back and take a look at it and talk about the promo record, why it was important, how it was used in those days with the radio stations and the record stores and things like that. And then also the rarity of the White Label promo. It's pretty cool. You know, it's interesting. And like I said, like mono is not really relevant today, but it is kind of cool to listen to, especially some of those old bands like the Beach Boys who would lay down like one track and that would be it. And so their mono records, to me, I mean, I don't know, it's pretty cool to listen to. So hope you enjoyed this episode. We'll come back with another episode. I'm gonna be doing another Partridge Family album. Hint, throwing down a hint there on an upcoming episode really soon. So we'll be talking about that. Thanks again for joining me. I hope you enjoyed my Partridge Family collection, and we'll see you next time.